What is the worst attitude that someone can have? Is it being unthankful, or let's say ungrateful, thankless? Is it to be haughty? Is it to be extremely arrogant? What's the worst attitude that someone can have? Or better said, what's the most dangerous and most self-destructive attitude someone can take? The worst, or with worst I mean the most self-destructive attitude anyone can take, is when they want to be left alone, when they want to be relieved. When someone's holding on to quote-unquote private comfort, that's the most self-destructive attitude ever. Someone is arrogant, at least reveals that he is aiming for something. Someone that's ungrateful, I don't support it, absolutely not. They show that they are in need. They show they are in trouble because they can't relate well to others. But someone that just want to be relieved, want to be left alone, the reason it's so self-destructive is because, one, you're not alert, so you can't notice danger or abnormalities when they occur. That's quite dangerous. And secondly, you're blinded. You think you're perfectly fine while the opposite is going on. You're not fine. You are trapped. But folks, once they are into this attitude of wanting to be left alone, they become militant in defending their private comfort. There is no such thing as private comfort in reality. But in their mind, they have what they consider their comfort zone, their life, based on their will, which you don't examine, and they want to keep it that way. They want to have control, and they also have the reasons for refusing other people who don't match their expectations. If that's your attitude, then you have the worst attitude ever. Or I'm saying where you have the most self-destructive attitude that a human being can take. Someone that is in full rebellion is aware that they are in full rebellion, and eventually they can crack down and realize they need to change their mind. Am I supporting people being in full rebellion against the Most High? No, absolutely not. But someone that is in full rebellion is conscious that they need to change. Even if they don't want to change, they realize I need to change. And eventually they'll crack down. But someone that's so into their private comfort, they're oblivious. That's how they are. So any dark, any negative energy or any blizzard, you can have Satan himself that comes by and hangs with them, and they won't even mind. They don't care as long as they are relieved. This is the attitude narcissists have. But with narcissists, it's completely only centered around them. But this is the attitude narcissists have. And because with narcissists, it's completely only about them, you tend to notice how disturbing that attitude is. But when other people have it, who are not narcissists, you think, it's just they want to be left alone, they have their life, their privacy, their will, blah, blah, blah. Society tends to condone it. When you look at it objectively, this mentality of wanting to be left alone is self-destructive. And it's hindering the well-functioning of the community. Look, if someone works every day and he's out of work, then he needs to relax his body, relax his mind. And if he's married, if he has kids, and he spends some time with the kids, then you refrain from contacting an individual too much, because an individual needs his rest, his relaxation, and some time with his family. Okay? Such an individual, you can say you leave them alone. Why? Because they're contributing to to the well-functioning of the community, so they ought to be rewarded for doing that. You get what I'm saying? Or someone who just had an almost fatal accident and they're now recovering, the government would tell any debt collector, anyone, any court case, or if there's a court case against them, it has to wait because the individual needs to recover. Then you leave someone alone. Then you can say you have to leave them alone. Leave them at ease. Leave them alone simply means leave them at ease. But if someone is contributing to harm to the community, either by omission or commission, you don't leave them alone. You don't give them space to be at ease while doing evil. No, you trouble them. You make it hard onto them so that they realize, hold on a minute, change needs to happen. But someone that is in this attitude, want to be left alone, would say that the individual is doing evil, well, he has a free will, he has a right to will whatever he wills, so you need to allow them to will that evil. As long as they don't harm people too much, just let them be. What? So hold on a minute. So when destruction is manifesting in your community, you let it be. You don't take actions to prevent the destruction from spreading around. You don't enforce repercussions on those who perpetrated the destruction. Just let them be. Are you crazy? Believers are constructed. They're instructed to pray all the time. To pray, not just every day, but pray all the time. Prayer should be your lifestyle. Prayer should be what you do, just like breathing. Why? Because believers have to put their environment in check. That's what we ought to do. But pagan Christianity taught you to leave people alone. Look, if someone came you into their danger, then you walk away from them, you shake dust off your feet. But even the shaking the dust off your feet against them is a repercussion against them. So you don't give them the right to be in the condition they are. Your shaking dust off your feet and removing you from them is in itself a judgment against them. You get what I'm saying here? You console people and you have sympathy for people to get them out of danger. You're not going to sympathize with them so that to keep them, to make them comfortable in danger. But that is what the narcissist wants. The narcissist doesn't want to face the danger that they're in. They don't want to face the danger of their way of thinking. Even though they may realize it, they want to be relieved from it. So they want to have sympathy from you, and they want to draw people in their danger so they can get sympathy from those people. And they don't care whether their danger harms you, affects you, or even kills you. As long as they get their sympathy, that's how narcissists are. They just want to be relieved when we're left alone. Now, with a narcissist, it's obvious that this attitude is self-destructive. But when others have it, we then excuse it. Don't excuse it. You should be alert, practical, and flexible. You should be realistic. But worldly people or common people, their attitude is, in general, if it doesn't affect my personal comfort, then it's none of my business. Then I'm not responsible for anything. They don't want any responsibility to anything unless it relieves them. So therefore, faith and responsibility is really absence without leave. If you're in the military, you need permission to have a day off. If you have a day off without having a leave to permission, you will face repercussions by the military. Now, there are folks who want absence without leave when it comes to life itself. There is no leave from life. In the military, you can get a leave of permission to get away from the military for a while. But from life, there is no leave. So you can't be absent from life and at the same time have the benefits of life. This isn't going to work. And look at this, those folks that just want to be left alone, they are the ones submitting to tyrannical governments. They're the ones that are, quote unquote, justifying child abuse and many other abominations as long as their relief is secured. Because that's the only thing on their mind. They have a narcissistic attitude. It doesn't mean they're all narcissists, but they have a narcissistic attitude. That's why, be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Don't conform to the pattern of this world. Agree with Christ and be at peace.